We'll speak few words, then we will close this session. Thank you. Friends and comrades, revolutionary greetings to everyone. Everyone who have been fighting, who have been part of the movement Justice for Rohit, and who became the victims of the police brutality. And this, actually the two events at two universities raised up new debate in our country. One thing on nationalism versus anti-nationalism. And this incident and the further events opened up discussions on caste discrimination and how the right-wing forces are trying to encourage the caste hegemony again. So this, our fight, actually we have been fighting since we realized that this incident is not a national driven, but it can happen to any one of us. And since we realized that a lot of politics have involved in this outside politics. So being part of SFI, I have been part of this movement since the beginning. From the day the circular was sent to the five Dalit scholars to vacate their rooms and forcibly lock. And the incident, unfortunately, our friend Rohit committed suicide on 17 January. So actually, apart from the politics, there are two reasons which made me to actually participate in this movement. I want to share them with you now. One thing is the realization of caste discrimination in our society, and another is, in this particular incident, the involvement of politics of the right-wing forces. So the caste discrimination and the caste hegemony, the structure of the caste, is a reality of in our society. We have been, every one of us are experiencing, whatever caste we belong, we have been experiencing since our childhood, consciously or unconsciously. Even I have experienced it. I have been part of the suppressed, and being from OBC community, even I, unknowingly, I was the oppressor of some people also, but I didn't know that time. But after coming to the university, the programs and talks conducted by the various progressive organizations made me to realize, made me conscious about the caste discrimination and the how it operates in our daily life. So I thank to all progressive organizations for enlightening me on this issue. And one thing, so it is clearly evident from the events that have followed after the suicide and also from the suspension of five Dalit scholars, the letter sent by MHRD to the university, so the autonomy of education institutes has been, they are trying to bring back the Varna system again, and trying to form Agraharas in our university. We have to look closely at this process, because the way of reaching them to the students is because we being in a diversified country, we are emotionally attached to the kind of national sentiments, because we have the history of the freedom movement and everything. So taking that as an advantage, they are trying to spread this kind of suppression on the background class, and they are trying to bring back the old society, old forms. So we have experienced the police brutality. We have experienced the strategies of the ruling government to suppress the movement and everything. So they attacked us, they threatened us, they sent us to prison. But they don't know that every attempt to suppress this movement will only strengthen the movement, will only make us stronger and stronger. So, from as a science student, I am from IMSC Physics. From the beginning it is like that. And many people are telling us also in prison and everywhere, the involvement of science students and faculty is very less. I want to tell the science community in this university and in the entire nation that it is only because of the constitution you are able to conduct research on various topics that have come from the European. Because if the constitution is not there, if the point of scientific temper, giving importance to scientific temper, is not included in the constitution, though you are interested in some genetic technology or any application of the science, you will be restricted to conduct research on yoga, this kind of old practices. So remember that it is because of the only constitution and the Ambedkar, you are able to perform your researches in this science lab. So now, this is the point where you have directly seen in our university the police brutality. Police have violated many constitution laws. When in Moinabad police station, we asked them that about the, what is the further procedure, where we will be sent, so what is this, because this is not, because we have to be produced before magistrate, before 24 hours. So when we are asking, they are saying that just we are law executors. If you want to change the law, that law makers are in parliament and everything. But how can they execute law by violating constitutional laws at the same time? So the basic human rights were denied in our university. We were sent to jail, but here the condition was very bad. The electricity, water, Wi-Fi, everything was cut off. So I thank the UH alumni and the people who opened their homes for the UH students. I thank the alumni and the students who actively participated in making food in messes and everything. So we will not stop this struggle till the VC, he is not a VC, Apparao is arrested. So for social justice, for Rohit, for social justice we shall fight, we shall win. Jai Bhim.